Please turn your Bibles to the book of Joshua, and we're going to read verse 1. Chapter 1, beginning with the first verse. After the death of Moses, the servant of the Lord, it came to pass that the Lord spoke to Joshua, the son of Nun, Moses' assistant, saying, Moses, my servant, is dead. Now, therefore, arise, go over this Jordan, you and all these people, to the land which I have given to them, the children of Israel. Every place that the sole of your foot will tread upon, I have given you, as I said to Moses, from the wilderness and this Lebanon, as far as the great river, the river Euphrates, all the land of the Hittites, and the great sea, toward the going down of the sun, shall be your territory. No man shall be able to stand before you all the days of your life. As I was with Moses, so I will be with you. I will not leave you nor forsake you. Be strong and of good courage, for to these people you shall divide as an inherit the land which I swore to their fathers to give them. Only be strong and very courageous, that you may observe to do according to all the law which Moses, my servant, commanded you. Do not turn from it to the right hand or to the left, that you may prosper wherever you go. This book of the law shall not depart from your mouth, but you shall meditate in it day and night, that you may observe to do according to all that is written in it, for then you will make your way prosperous, and then you will have good success. Have I not commanded you, be strong and of good courage? Do not be afraid or be dismayed, for the Lord your God is with you wherever you go. You're talking about courage, you're talking about things going well, success, you have it there in the first chapter of the book of Joshua. I continue with the sermons fulfilling my divine purpose. Every one of you have a divine purpose. And this morning's study is preparing for your assignment. There's a spiritual preparation before you're launched out by God. So it works. First, repeat after me, an encounter with God.
Encounter with God.
Then we are called.
Then we are called.
And then we are sent. First is an encounter, then the calling comes, and then the assignment, the purpose, we are sent. And all the great men of the Bible went through this process. First, they came face to face with God. Then God called them for something, and then God sent them out. And this is the same as it was in the Bible. With the people of God, it's the same with you and the same with me. It all begins with an encounter with God. An encounter is when we come to the altar, when we open our heart, when we accept Jesus as our personal Savior, this is our first encounter with God. Face to face with God. Then after that, it comes a calling. God puts a fire in you, it starts stirring up in your heart, that fire. To do something, and then is the clear up in your heart, in your mind, and then God sends you to do His assignment, His work. It can be witnessing to someone, opening a Bible study, serving with the children, or going to the mission field. But we all have an assignment. like, and as we come to the conclusion of the month of October, if one thing we learn in this month is that we're called by God, and God has bestowed on us something to do. We all have that. No exception. You're not an idol. We all have that. This morning, I want us to see the life of Joshua. We're going to learn from Joshua. Why was he so successful? Here you have a man that has a great task. He's going to divide the territory of Israel, the promised land, into the different 12 tribes, close to 3 million people. It's not an easy work. But I want us to see his preparation. He didn't know exactly what he was going to do. Like most of us don't know the full dimension of God's calling. God calls you, but he will not explain everything you're going to do. Like God likes to surprise you. He surprises me. Surprises me. I think that, oh, wow, I did this for the Lord. And then I turn the page and, wow, a new continent opens. A new frontier opens. A new opportunity opens. And what can I say? I love it, I love it, I love it, I love it. Hallelujah. Give a hand clap for Christ. Thank you. So Joshua, because he was a man with a spiritual dimension, he knew that God has something for him. How big, how great, he did not know. But he knew he had something great from God. So fulfilling, faithful to receive, Exodus 33:10. So the Lord spoke to Moses face to face, as a man speaks to his friend. And he will return to the camp, but his servant Joshua, the son of Nun, a young man, did not depart from the tabernacle. That really called my attention. This young man did not depart from the tabernacle. I want to know why he did depart from the tabernacle. And I'm going to give you what the Lord showed me. Why he did not depart from the tabernacle. First of all, Joshua had an insight on spiritual matters, spiritual dimension. And this is what we need in our lives. And I pray that all of us will have a spiritual insight of things. When you have a spiritual insight, you can discern the things of the Spirit. Because the things of the Spirit can only be discerned by spiritual. The carnal cannot discern the things of the Spirit. So he had an insight of spiritual things. First of all, number one, he knew or he accepted and he took that God is omnipotent, the only God, Jehovah, Elohim. God is God. He understood that. For other people, they were still thinking of Egypt. They were still thinking on the images. They were still thinking in other things.